I read that and I went, whoa. It took me back to Colombia. It took me all over the place with lots of different ideas.
That like the things that we're like most concerned about, like the things that we find the scariest are like some of the things that are like,
planes are way safer than cars, but we are way more scared of crashing in a plane than in a car, because when a plane crashes, it's like a huge thing and everyone hears about it because it happens way less often. Same thing with like,
what draws you to true crime? Like, why would you want to know? Why would you want to watch that? Back in August, there was a politician in Colombia who was assassinated, Miguel Uribe. Okay? He was assassinated on the streets of Bogota. And you know, Colombia is a country that had a fair amount of violence and was considered to be one of the most violent countries in the world not long ago. You know, the peace process has been implemented, but you know, they're struggling a little bit. But anyway, about a week after this, I went down to Colombia. That's when I took Julie her blue moon. And I wondered, I saw this headline, and I said, it inflames Colombia's political divisions. And I thought, wow, what? Wonder what's going to be happening. Now, I know Colombia pretty well. I have an apartment there. I spent a lot of time there. It wasn't just going to see a museum and, you know, that kind of thing, right? I got down to Colombia and there's nothing. Nobody was talking about it. Like a week later, no one's talking about it. It's not really in the news. But I saw the headline. And even me, as the person who's been to Colombia many, many, many times, I thought, whoa, I saw the headline and I thought, hey, this is big. It's an assassination, you know. Right after this, I saw this 750,000 years, and it came from this writer. He's a British writer. He wrote this book, How to Live Dangerously, and he calculated 750,000 years. What he said was, kidnapping in the United States is so rare, okay, that a child would have to be outside unsupervised for on average 750,000 years before that child was abducted or taken by a stranger. First off, I just want to hold that. Can you hold that? Everything you know about children and danger from strangers and so on, this is in the United States, okay? Everything you think about it, everything we talk about, 750, you take your child, every child play outside by herself or himself, it would take, on average, if everyone did that, 750,000 years before your child was kidnapped. You get it. Does it make sense? It makes sense, everybody? You get it? Okay. I read that, and I went, whoa. It took me back to Colombia. It took me all over the place with lots of different ideas. And I tried to dig around and figure out how he actually calculated that. But in a way, it doesn't matter. It matters, but it doesn't matter because maybe it's not exactly 750,000. But I have used very similar numbers as this because kidnapping, stranger kidnapping, is so rare anywhere in the world, really. Okay? But yet, it's one of the greatest fears, if not the single greatest fear of a parent, losing their child. So that's sits right there. Okay. So I thought, what an interesting idea or interesting topic or number to start us in a conversation. Okay, to have this conversation with you all, because I know what I think about these issues, but what do you think? So let me just start with one of you. What do you think about that number?
So it's like a really big number, which is like very surprising that it would be that big. But like once I start to think about it, it makes sense. Like I know that like kidnappings by strangers are incredibly rare and almost unheard of, and that's like why they make news when they do happen. And so like it's almost like surprising that like the things that we're like most concerned about, like the things that we find the scariest, are like some of the things that are like least likely to actually be to actually harm us, right? That like we're like way more scared about like kids getting kidnapped by strangers than we are about car crashes, when like car crashes are like the leading cause of death among children.
I grew up like watching a lot of true crime, or like I still watch a lot of true crime, and I think it's more about how much it gets reported, like how big of news it is. So like you like planes are way safer than cars, but we are way more scared of crashing in a plane than in a car, because when a plane crashes, it's like a huge thing and everyone hears about it because it happens way less often. Same thing with like probably kidnappings, because it's a, you know, because it's so rare, it gets reported and we have like Amber Alerts and stuff like that.
Right. So if it does get reported, it gets really widely reported, and then it's front page, it's a major thing. It's okay.
I'm not so aware about, you know, numbers and about, you know, like kidnapping crimes, but first to kind of introduce myself, I lived in Manila, Philippines. For about, I don't know, 11 years since I grew up there in, you know, like in my early elementary school years. So I think when it comes to kidnapping, like I've experienced, you know, like two cultures, but no, it's, I didn't like it experience kidnapping, but, the number itself seems really big, but, I'm really not aware how it is in Korea. I thought this was actually really safe, but you said, you know, it's much bigger there. So that's something that surprised me, actually.
So here's something that's interesting right now. There were a couple cases fairly recently of people who they thought had the intentions of kidnapping kids. I think two different cases. And it's another, there's this big response to it. Even though, by the way, Korea is really safe. Like, really safe. So, like, you know, can you say how safe Korea is?
So Korea is, I think, one of the safest country, you know, like for tourists to go and travel. Sure. Cause you know, whenever, I mean, I think it's similar in state college, cause to be honest, when I first came to America, you know, it was my state college is my first, you know, kind of destination in being in America. So I thought it would be really dangerous, but to be honest, I think it's a bit similar here. So whenever we go to cafes and we study there, if even though we put our laptops or our phone, our wallet, it's gonna stay there, you know, like, to be honest, like forever.
Yeah, you could go, like, one way you reserve a seat at a cafe and
yeah, so, and even though you put it there and, you know, go back there next day, I probably can assure that it's gonna be there. Yeah. Or, you know, like the cafe owner's gonna, you know, take it for you and then, you know,
you'd
give it back.
Take it. Yeah. No, they wouldn't even touch it because it's like, it's not there. So you wouldn't touch it. So, you know, it's similar in Saudi and Doha. There are a lot of other places, but for sure. But nonetheless, when I think about other countries and places, it's not that different, right? There are certain areas in Brazil, you know, you have wealthy elites. There are kidnapping rings in Brazil and so on. There is this issue, and we're going to come stay on this issue. I just want to say a couple things. There's this negativity bias that we have, that negative things or things that threaten us, we're more biased toward remembering what they are and really listening to what they are, and it's probably built into some kind of survival mechanism that we have. So, you know, and then in the media, of course, because of this, if it bleeds, it leads. And if it's violence, it's going to be a lead story, because people, we want to know. People just have this curiosity. Dude, why do you watch true crime, by the way? Yeah. What draws you to true crime? Like, why would you want to know? Why would you want to watch that?
I think it's like morbid curiosity. Like, you just kind of like want to know more about certain things and why people do certain things, or I don't, it's like, you know, when people say like something's a car crash, like it's terrible, but you can't look away, kind of like that,
you,
I guess.
When you finish watching things, do you feel more, to what degree do you feel more insecure?
With time, you just kind of get desensitized to it, and you just don't really, at the same time that you're more aware that it exists, if you feel like it's never going to happen to me.
My friend. you're probably not more desensitized to it. It stays in you. It's going to stay in you.
Especially like bringing it back to Brazil, like we watch all that stuff, like serial killers and like kidnappings and abductions and stuff like that here. Yeah. And no one makes documentaries about kidnappings and serial killers and stuff like that in Brazil because it just happens so. We have a lot of crime. It's not as dangerous as people think it is, but it's pretty dangerous. So like, again, if it happens a lot, it's not going to get that much attention.
It happens more than Korea.
Definitely.
Yeah. Yeah. So here's one other thing I want to say before we jump, off, go to the next slide. One thing that's really important is that, this is a sociology class. So the four of you, it's important that you know that I'm interested in averages. We're interested in groups. I'm not interested on the extreme ends. This is a bell curve. And if you look at the numbers, you'll notice how much is really inside, mostly the center of the bell curve. That's normal. It's the extreme ends. And crime becomes something that happens at the extreme ends. So I'm really curious about what's in the sort of normal space, right? That's the thing that I try to talk about more in here. It's kind of like racism, right? How much racism exists? Well, if I just asked everybody in the class who's ever experienced a really serious, had some serious experience of racism, maybe two people would raise their hand. And then it's like, is that a lot or is it not a lot? It's like, what is it? So keep that in mind.
Jacob asks, 750,000 years across 73 million children means kidnapping every 3.75 days, right? I've seen it as kidnapping occur twice a week. There's about 100 kidnappings a year by stranger kidnappings in the United States, about 100, right? So
100 kidnappings a year in the United States?
Right. Yeah, that would be about right. Yeah. No, it doesn't. Yeah, it doesn't change my thinking, actually. It's still quite rare. And it's surprising that it's, first off, given how afraid people are of strangers and stranger kidnappings and these kinds of things, especially as their children are concerned, the level of fear doesn't match with the level of possibility. For me, it would not. When I think about the entirety of the United States, if I had a child, my child would be playing outside all the time, unsupervised. I wouldn't have any problem with that. I would simply run the numbers and not have a problem with that. Yeah. So no, it doesn't change. Meister Yoda. Let's go to that one.